Right, take your Bible. We're really going to preach the word. Don't get in a hurry. God's going to do mighty miracles tonight.
Amen.
I tell you, people are going to walk out here healed by the power of Almighty God. If you've got a sickness in your body, this is the time to get healed. If you're longing for miracles, you can walk out here tonight and you can also perform miracles. It's not experience the miracles, it's to go out and do the miracles. The more people that can do the miracles, the more people will be healed. I tell you, in those last 2 weeks, I tell you, it's like God is just turning it up. And that's why I want to touch on this again tonight.
Amen.
Okay, Isaiah chapter 7, verse 10. Moreover, the Lord spoke again to King Ahaz, saying, ask for yourself a sign. I tell you, I can't get away from this. God is saying to the king, ask for a sign. I want to start off right at the outset of this meeting tonight. This is not some preacher talking. This is Almighty God.
That's right.
God is saying to the king, why don't you ask me for a sign? So God wants to give signs to people.
Yes.
God wants to do wonders and miracles in the lives of people.
Yes.
And in every situation. So God is saying to the king, ask of me a sign. Now, I want you to look at the Amplified. Just read verse 11.
Ask for a sign.
Ask for a sign.
A token.
A token.
Or proof.
Or a proof.
Of the Lord your God.
Yeah.
One that will convince you.
One that will convince you.
That God has spoken and will keep his word.
God is saying to the king, you can ask me for a sign. You can ask me for a token. You can ask me for a proof. You can ask me for something that will convince you that I, the Lord, has spoken. Rest, Peter.
Ask it either in the depth below.
So you can go down to hell and ask it from there.
Or in the height above.
You can go up to heaven and ask it from there.
Let it be as deep as Sheol or as high as heaven.
God is saying there's no restrictions. There's no boundaries. You can go as far as you want to, you can go as low as you want to. But I tell you, if you ask me for a sign, a token, or a proof that'll convince you that I, the Lord, have spoken, I will give you such a sign.
Yes, amen.
And we're too scared to ask God for signs. Oh, no, 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 no. No, you want to hear about proof, nibuti. Yeah, money, you come from for a teken. Oh. Yeah, bro, ek vra teken. Gideon gesê, Here, it moet daar reen, en dan moet het daar reen, dan moet het daar reen. Here, it's all right, reen, reen, reen. Nee, bro, maar nou het ons die Heilige Geest, ons moet nie nou tekens vra nie. Sevi, is God's word changing day by day? Or is God the same yesterday, today, and forever? Does Malachi 3 verse 6 says, I am the Lord and I change not? Or is God forever changing? God is saying to Ahaz, if you ask me a sign, if you ask me a token, if you ask me a proof, something that will convince you. I tell you, there's people that are still not convinced. There's a lady that's been healed of two cancers last week. There's my boy that died by falling on his head on Wednesday. He's alive. There's people sitting here right now that's still not convinced. So the king said, I will not tempt God, and I will not ask for a sign. That's verse 12. The king said, no, God, I will not ask for a sign. Then God comes in the next verse and says, but I will give a sign. Read it, Peter.
And Isaiah said, hear then, O house of David, is it a small thing for you to weary and try the patience of men? But will you weary and try the patience of my God also? Therefore, the Lord himself shall give
now
you a sign.
Now listen and listen carefully. This guy's, no, 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 no. We cannot tempt God with signs and wonders and miracles and powers. God says.
Therefore, the Lord himself shall give you a sign.
Okay, just there. The Lord God Almighty. Listen, people, I want to challenge you tonight. The Lord will. If you want a sign or not, I'm going to give you a sign in any case. The Lord God Almighty will give.
Yes, amen.
Will give
amen.
You a sign. Will give you a token.
Yes.
Will give you a proof.
Yes.
That will convince you that God has spoken. In other words, that his word is true.
Yes,
read.
Behold, the young woman who is unmarried and a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us.
God says, ask me for a sign, ask me for a token, ask me for a proof that'll convince you that I, the Lord, have spoken. Or in other words, that my word is true. Isaiah 55:11 says, so shall my word be that proceeded from my mouth. It shall do what I have sent it for and be prosperous therein, and it will not return unto me void. Psalm 107 verse 20 said, he has sent his word to heal them and deliver them from all destruction. John 1 verse 1 through 14 says, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Everything that was made by him, and without him was nothing made that was made. Verse 14 says, and this word became flesh, God in man, God in man. The word became flesh. Emmanuel equals the word is now in flesh. The word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. Verse 14, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, filled with grace and mercy. Now the Bible says, this is the sign. If you want it or not, I'm going to give it to you. The sign is Emmanuel. God is now with us. And this is the greatest sign that any person can desire on this earth. The sign is not the healing. The sign is not the power. The sign is not the glory. That's attributes of the sign. But if you want a sign, Emmanuel. When we visited Synagogue Church of All Nations in Lagos, Nigeria, with Prophet T.B. Joshua nearly 2 years ago, and they picked us up at the airport, they stopped there with a bus, and everybody that greeted us said, Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel. There's 3-4 guys there. Emmanuel. I said, why don't they say hello? Why don't they say peace? Why don't they say hi? Emmanuel, Emmanuel. We're here from South Africa. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel. Can these people say anything else? Emmanuel, Emmanuel. So we arrived there the Tuesday night at 9 o'clock. The Wednesday morning at 4 o'clock, the Sikhs started coming in. And everybody greeted everybody else with Emmanuel, Emmanuel. Here by 11 o'clock, I tell you, we had about 10 testimonies already of people that's been healed of cancer, cripples that walked, lame people that jumped up. And one after the other, miracles started happening, and people started testifying about the greatness and the goodness and the kindness of God. And God is working, and God is working, and God is working. I said, why do everybody say Emmanuel? So they started testifying. The guy said, well, before I testify, can we have 3 Emmanuels? Anybody? Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel. And I said, what's this Emmanuel? So I looked at it, and God started speaking to me. He said, Emmanuel is the greatest sign, token, proof that can convince people that God has spoken. The sign is Emmanuel. God is with us. So every time they say Emmanuel, they say a sign, a token, a proof to convince people that God spoke. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, a sign, a token, a proof to convince people that God spoke. The word became flesh. Emmanuel, God is with us. Acts chapter 2. And you can read that in Matthew 1, where the angel appeared to Joseph and said, don't put Mary away, but take her as your wife. For she shall bear a son and call his name Jesus, and he shall save his people from their sin. And this is a sign. the virgin shall conceive and bear a child, and this is the sign. Yeah. His name shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us. I tell you, if you want a sign, get God with you. Get God with you. Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2. Wonderful Jesus. Now, Jesus was crucified. Emmanuel came, they crucified him. They didn't want him. They crucified him. They did not want God with them. All of a sudden, the greatest sign of all times is there. God is finally amongst people. And they said, no, we don't want God with us. So they crucified him. But just before they crucified him, Jesus said, hey, 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 they're going to take one out of the way. And the one that made me that, I'm going to send him. Down. So you must be happy that I'm now going. Then the one that made me that, I'm going to send him there, because the fullness of the Godhead dwelt bodily in Christ Jesus, and we have this fullness in him. So be glad that I go, because I will send you another comforter, the Holy Spirit, the one that made me Emmanuel. And once he come, then it'll not just be me that is now the word that's flesh. It's not just me that'll carry God around. It's not just me that'll cause God to be with you. Now, Peter, it's going to be you. James, it's going to be you. John, it's going to be you. Bartholomew, it's going to be you. Thaddeus, it's going to be you. Paul says, before I was born, this is what I was made for. To reveal God to the world. He said, and you know what? When I came to you, you received me as an angel, comma, no, you received me as God himself, because you realized it was God in me. Right. Emmanuel. Right. This is the sign. And then the outflow of the sign. So Jesus was crucified, promised them the Holy Spirit, received the Holy Spirit, poured it out on the church. Peter stood up and he preached. Verse 22, ye men of Israel, listen to what I have to say. This is now Peter after he received the Holy Spirit preaching on the day of Pentecost. You men of Israel, listen to what I have to say. Jesus of Nazareth, a man, you got to read it to me, Peter. Jesus of Nazareth, a man.
Accredited.
Listen, listen, accredited.
And pointed out.
Pointed out.
Shown forth.
Shown forth.
And commended.
And commended.
And attested.
Woo! Attested.
To you by God, by the mighty works and the power of.
By the mighty works.
And the power of performing.
And the power of performing.
Wonders.
Wonders.
And signs.
And signs. Woo!
Which God has worked through him right in your midst.
Ask for a sign. Ask for a token. Ask for a proof. Ask for anything that will convince you that God spoke and that his word is true. No, 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 no. We want to. God says, hey, wait, I'm going to give you a sign. If you want it or not, the sign is Emmanuel. The word that will convince you will now become flesh. Don't miss one word. The word that will convince you that God spoke and that signs, tokens will be a proof is this word will now become flesh. Then we will say, Emmanuel. God is with us. Peter preaches. He said, you have crucified Jesus, a man that was accredited. That's his CV. Pointed. Shown. Commended. Attested. With mighty works. And power. And wonders. Come on. And signs that God wrought by him. Now Peter goes on. He says, this Jesus you have crucified. Verse 32 says, but this Jesus has God raised up from the dead. Verse 33 says, being therefore lifted high by and to the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promised blessing, which is the Holy Spirit, he has made this outpouring, which you yourselves both see and hear. Whoo! He says, so you have crucified him, the one that was accredited, the man, Emmanuel, the one that is called God with us, the one who is the sign, the token, the proof that will convince people that God is finally here. This is the only way God can convince people, Emmanuel. The only way he can convince us is God with us. And that word, God made flesh, Emmanuel. So he's now with us, and God accredited him. God pointed him out. God shown him forth. God has commended him. God has attested him with mighty works and power and wonders and signs. But you crucified him. Tough luck, baby. God raised him up from the dead. And after he received the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has now poured it out. What you now see and what you now hear. So sorry that you've crucified him. He was alone. Now there's 120 of us. Watch out, baby. Tomorrow we're going to be 3,000. Watch out, man. We're going to be 7,000. Watch out, man. The whole earth will be filled with the glory of the Lord. I tell you, the day is coming, and it's arriving very soon, where people are going to realize, Emmanuel. Yes. Wow. 1 Corinthians and 14 says, and they will come and say, we can see that God is with you. They will come and say, we can see that God is with you. Now, this is a lekker kerk. Ons hou van julle selgroepe. Ons hou van julle worship. Ons hou van die pastoor. Ons hou van die kerk. But what about, can we say, God is in die plek. Come on. There's so many visitors here tonight. Who, how many has said this? Hey, something. Don't be ashamed. Who came to me and who said, hey, it's iets in hierdie plek. What say you? What say? People come to me and say, Kobus, God is in die plek. What they're actually saying is, Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel. We can experience God is worth you. Because God accredited, pointed, shown, commended, attested the Emmanuel sign with works, power, wonders, and signs. So if this is not there, then he's not there. If this is not there, he's not there. Kom as jy sê God is nie in my kerk nie. No. But yes. But no, but yes. Opakke en dale en oor al is God. Waar ons ook telke male mag swerwe daar. God is all over, omniscient, omnipresent, all knowing. He knows everything. He's all over. But in manifest presence, he's not all over. How do you know that, Kubus? Well, in Exodus 3, there was a bush that was burning on a mountain. And there was a guy attending the sheep of his father-in-law, Jethro. And he saw the bush, and hy kom nuuskierig nader. What's happening? He's carpeted. Hulle cheer Moses on, sê, handjek, 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 So Moses kom neskierig na, and all of a sudden God said to Moses, let's just make it short. God said, Moses, go take my children, lead them out of Egypt. I will be with you. In Exodus, God said it again in Exodus 23, in Exodus 24, in Exodus 25, I'm with you, I'm with you. In Exodus 33, Moses saw God in all his glory. God and Moses had a face-to-face experience. And Moses said, oh God, if I take your people, who will you send with us? And God said, Moses, do you want me to personally go with you? Moses, do you want me to personally go with you? Exodus 33 and verse 16. Moses said, oh Lord. Hey. God says, Moses, I will grant you this request. I myself will go with you.
Wow.
But on the outside, they will just see me as a pillar of fire and as a cloud. But it's actually me that's there, but I'm covering myself with clouds. And at nighttime, the fire of my presence will shine through so it'll look like a pillar of fire. But it's still the same cloud. At daytime, when the sun is shining, you can't see the fire because the cloud is too thick. It looks like a cloud. But it's actually, I'm with you. And Moses said, if God is not with us, let us not go from here. He said, but if God is with us, this will be the only sign. Read it for us. Just that one verse, Peter.
For by what shall it be known?
Listen, by what shall it be known?
That I and your people have found favor in your sight.
Okay. What is the sign? Look here, quick. Into the block, check. What is the sign? What is the token? What is the proof that'll convince people that God spoke to us? Okay?
Is it not in your going with us?
Is it not that God is with us?
So that we are distinguished?
Listen, that we are distinguished. That we are distinguished.
I and your people from all the other people upon the face
from
of the earth.
From all the other people on the face of the earth. Lord, how will it be known that we are different from other people? Will it not be in this one thing that God is with us? Come on, people, don't look too shocked. But what makes one church different than another church? The worship? No, you get used to worship quickly. The preaching? No, you get used to preaching quickly. What makes one church? Why is it that people point fingers at churches? What is the thing that'll cause people to talk about a certain church? There's only one thing that'll make you a church that people will point fingers at, that people will gossip about, that people will backbite, that people will slander. Only one thing that'll distinguish you to be different from all the other churches. It's signs, wonders, miracles. So that is the token that God is with you. They don't write about preachers talking in tongues. They don't write about preachers laying hands on people. They don't write about preachers prophesying. They don't write about preachers marrying people or burying people. But broer, kry jy uit die rolstoel en almal praat vir jou. Hulle sal eers dit bietjie goed maak and then they'll nail you. Why? Because all of a sudden you're different. And if they talk good about the miracles, then they've got to start performing to look good as well. So they rather try and see what they can say wrong about you so that they won't look so bad. And one group of people say, oh Lord, we want it. The other group says, must be Satan. God knows why I've got to preach this. God, whereby shall it be known that we are distinguished from all the other people? Will it not be in the fact that God is with us with signs, with wonders, with miracles? When Caleb and Joshua came to spy on the land, and 40 years later, the other spies came to spy on the land, because they had to dwell in the desert for 40 years to get rid of the unbelieving generation. When the next generation came to Canaan and walked in there, the people got a hold of them and said, "We heard about you, how God has done this miracles, how God has wrought this power, how God has brought this science, and the whole nation is already trembling because you are distinguished from all the other people on the face of the earth, because we can see that God is with you." I'm preaching this for you. I'm preaching this for me. I'm preaching this for our nation. Isn't it time that we can have more miracles? God is with us. A Red Sea open, a Jordan River open, bread fall from heaven, meat fly and fall on the ground. Signs, God is with us. John the Baptist was the cousin to the Lord Jesus Christ. They played together as little boys. They were cousins, man. Mary and Elizabeth loved one another. So Jesus and John must have grown up together. Huayin clay lot there in the flare. Growing up together. John grew up to be the forerunner, to prepare the way in the desert. So one day he was baptizing at the Jordan River, preaching to the Pharisees and Sadducees, "Why are you running away from the wrath of God? How do you think you can escape? I'll be baptized, baptized, baptize the people unto repentance, baptize." All of a sudden, John stopped, pointed his finger at the masses of people and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world." Here comes Jesus out of the crowd. "Baptize me, John." Said, no, it's you that should baptize me. "No, John, baptize me, and I hope I'll get the time to preach this message to you one day. Baptize me, John, so that all righteousness might be fulfilled." That is a sermon I've got to preach sometime. "Baptize me, John, so that all righteousness may be fulfilled." Remember Hebrews 1:9, how God anointed Jesus Christ above his fellow men because he hated unrighteousness and loved righteousness. "Baptize me, John." No, Jesus, baptize me. No, John, baptize me so that all righteousness. "And when I baptized him, the voice spoke to me and said, the one on whom you see the Spirit descend and stay on him, it is he that will baptize with the Holy Ghost and with fire. And John said, I saw the heavens open, the Holy Spirit coming down in bodily form like a dove, and a voice spoke, said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." John said, "Hey, I was there. I saw. I heard. I came. And I went." Amen. This is him. So John said, "That's a lamb. That's a lamb of God. He takes away. He's going to take away the sin." Hey Jesus, why didn't you tell me, man? I mean, now you wait till you come here, Jesus. Why didn't you just tell me, man? Now I'm standing here, man. You come, God in the flesh. Oh, Jesus, man, why didn't you just tell me? Why didn't you just inform me? Lamb of God, Emmanuel, Jesus. Couple of weeks later, John is in prison, sends his disciples to Jesus. ask him the question, Matthew 11 verse 2. Send his disciples. The disciples came, said, Jesus, John sent us to ask you, are you the one, Emmanuel, that was to come? Or should we expect another one to come? Jesus said, why don't you just go back to John and tell him what you see and what you hear? The lame walk, the blind see, the cripples run, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the gospel is being preached. So they came back to John. They said, John, we came to Jesus and we asked him, is he Emmanuel or isn't he Emmanuel? Is this the one? Or should we? And he said, go tell John, you see signs, wonders, and miracles. John said, it's him. Thank you, Jesus.